I know what my people are thinking tonight, as home through the shadows they wander. Everyone smiling in secret delight, they stare at the castle and ponder. Whenever the wind blows this way, you can almost hear everyone say, I wonder what the king is doing tonight. What merriment is the king pursuing tonight? The candles at the court, they never burned as bright. I wonder what the king is up to tonight. How goes the final hour as he sees the bridal bower being regally and legally prepared? Well, I'll tell you what the king is doing tonight. He's scared. He's scared. You mean that a king who fought a dragon, whacked him in two and fixed his wagon, goes to be wed in terror and distress? Yes. A warrior who's so calm in battle, even his armor doesn't rattle, faces a woman petrified with fright? Right. You mean that appalling clamoring that sounds like a blacksmith hammering is merely the banging of his royal knees? Please. You wonder what the king is wishing tonight. He's wishing he were in Scotland fishing tonight. What occupies his time while waiting for the bride? He's searching high and low for some place to hide. And oh, the expectation, the sublime anticipation he must feel about the wedding night to come. Well, I'll tell you what the king is feeling tonight. He's numb, he shakes, he quails, he quakes. And that's what the king is doing tonight. It's true. It's true. The Crown has made it clear. The climate must be perfect all the year. A law was made a distant moon ago here. July and August cannot be too hot. And there's a legal limit to the snow here in Camelot. The winter is forbidden till December, and exits March the 2nd on the dot. By order, summer lingers through September in Camelot. Camelot, Camelot. I know it sounds a bit bizarre, but in Camelot, Camelot, that's how conditions are. The rain may never fall till after sundown. By 8, the morning fog must disappear. In short, there's simply not a more congenial spot for happily ever aftering than here in Camelot. Camelot, I know it gives a person pause, but in Camelot, Camelot, those are the legal laws. The snow may never slush upon the hillside. By 9 p.m. the moonlight must appear. In short, there's simply not a more congenial spot for happily ever aftering than here in Camelot.
Camelot, Camelot, and here am I to give my all. I know in my soul what you expect of me, and all that and more I shall be. A knight of the Table Round should be invincible. Succeed when a less fantastic man would fail. Climb a wall no one else can climb. Cleave a dragon in record time. Swim a moat in a coat of heavy iron mail. No matter the pain, he ought to be unwincible. Impossible deeds should be his daily fare. But where in the world is there in the world a man so extraordinaire? C'est moi, I'm forced to admit, 'tis I humbly reply. That mortal who these marvels can do, c'est moi, 'tis I. I've never lost in battle or game, I'm simply the best by far. When swords are crossed, 'tis always the same, one blow and au revoir. C'est moi, so admirably fit, a French Prometheus unbound. And here I stand with valor untold, exceptionally brave, amazingly bold, to serve at the Table Round. The soul of a knight should be a thing remarkable, his heart and his mind as pure as morning dew. With a will and a self-restraint that's the envy of every saint, he could easily work a miracle or two. To love and desire, he ought to be unsparkable. The ways of the flesh should offer no allure. But where in the world is there in the world a man so untouched and pure? C'est moi, c'est moi, I blush to disclose, I'm far too noble to lie. That man in whom these qualities bloom, c'est moi, 'tis I. I've never strayed from all I believe, I'm blessed with an iron will. Had I been made the partner of Eve, we'd be in Eden still. C'est moi, the angels have chose to fight their battles below. And here I stand as pure as a prayer, incredibly clean, with virtue to spare, the godliest man I know. C'est moi!
Lusty month of May, that lovely month when everyone goes blissfully astray. Tra-la, it's here, that shocking time of year, when tons of wicked little thoughts merrily appear. It's May, that gorgeous holiday, when every maiden prays that her lad will be a cad. It's mad, it's gay, a libelous display, those dreary vows that everyone takes, everyone breaks, everyone makes divine mistakes, the nasty months of May. Whence this fragrance wafting through the air? What sweet feelings does it scent transmute? Whence this perfume floating everywhere? Don't you know it's that dear forbidden fruit? Tra-la-la-la-la, that dear forbidden fruit. Tra-la-la-la-la. Tra-la-la-la-la. Tra-la-la. Tra-la. Tra-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la. It's May, the lusty month of May, that darling month when everyone throws self-control away. It's time a wretched thing or two, and try to make each precious day one you'll always rue. It's May, the month of yes you may, the time for every frivolous whim, proper or impropper. world, it's gay, a blot in every way. The birds and bees with all of their vast amorous past gaze at the human race aghast. Said you might serve as my escort at the next town fair. Well, I'm afraid there's someone who I must invite in place of you, someone who plainly is beyond compare. That Frenchman's power is more tremendous than I have ever seen anywhere. And when a man is that stupendous, he by right should take me to the fair.
Your Majesty, let me tilt with him and smite him. Don't refuse me so abruptly, I implore. Oh, give me the opportunity to fight him, and Gaul will be divided once more.
You will bash and thrash him?
I'll smash and mash him.
You'll give him trouble?
He will be rubble.
A mighty whack.
His skull will crack.
Well, then you take me to the fair. If you do all the things you promise, in fact my heart would break should you not take me to the fair. Sir Sagramore, I have some rather painful news relative to the subject who's to be beside me at the next court ball. You were the chosen one, I know, but as tradition it should go to the unquestioned champion in the hall. And I'm convinced that splendid Frenchman can easily conquer one and all. And besting all our local henchmen, he should sit beside me at the ball.
I beg of you, ma'am, withhold your invitation. I swear to you this challenge will be met. And when I've finished up the operation, I'll serve him to your highness en brochette.
You'll pierce right through him.
I'll barbecue him.
A wicked thrust.
'Twill be dust to dust.
From fore to aft.
He'll feel a draught.
Well then, you may sit by me at the ball if you demolish him in battle. In fact, I know I'd cry were you not by me at the ball. Sir Dinadan, didn't I promise that you may guide me to London on the day that I go up to judge the cattle show? As it is quite a nasty ride, there must be someone at my side who'll be defending me from beast and foe. So when I choose whom I prefer go, I take the strongest knight I know. And young Dulac seems strongest, ergo he should take me to the cattle show.
Your Majesty can't believe this blustering prattle. Let him prove it with a sword or lance instead. I promise you when I've done this gory battle, his shoulders will be lonesome for his head.
You'll disconnect him.
I'll vivisect him.
You'll open wide him.
I'll subdivide him.
Oh, dear, 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 dear. Then you may guide me to the show if you can carry out your program. In fact, I'd grieve inside should you not guide me to the show.
Milady,
we shall put an end to that Gallic bag of noise and nerve. When we do all that we intend to, there'll be a plate of French hors d'oeuvre.
I do applaud your noble goals. Now let us see if you achieve them. And if you do, then you will be the three who will go to the ball, to the show.
Do I flatter her? I begged him, answer. Do I threaten or cajole or plead? Do I brood or play the gay romancer? Said he, smiling, no indeed. How to handle a woman? Mark me well, I will tell you, sir. The way to handle a woman is to love her, simply love her, merely love her, love her, love her. Tell you, sir, the way to handle a woman is to love her, simply love her, merely love her, love her.
Goodbye.
you in summer, I never would go. Your hair streaked with sunlight, your lips red as flame, your face with a luster that puts gold to shame. But if I'd ever leave you, how could it be in autumn? How I'd leave in autumn, I never would know. I've seen how you sparkle when fall nips the air. I know you in autumn, and I must be there. And could I leave you running merrily through the snow? Or on a wintry evening when you catch the fire's glow? If ever I would leave you, how could it be in springtime? Knowing how in spring I'm bewitched by you so. Springtime, knowing how in spring I'm bewitched by you so. Oh no, not in springtime, summer, winter, or fall. No, never could I leave you.
The seven deadly virtues, those ghastly little traps. Oh no, my liege, they were not meant for me. Those seven deadly virtues were made for other chaps who love a life of failure and ennui. Take courage, now there's a sport, an invitation to the state of rigor mort. And purity, a noble yen, and very restful every now and then. I find humility means to be hurt. It's not the earth the meek inherit, it's the dirt. Honesty is fatal, it should be taboo. Diligence, a fate I would hate. If charity means giving, I give it to you. And fidelity is only for your mate. Ha! You'll never find a virtue on statusing my quo or making my Beelzebubble burst. Let others take the high road, I will take the low. I cannot wait to rush in where angels fear to go. With all those seven deadly virtues, free and happy little me has not been cursed.
What do the simple folk do to help them escape when they're blue? The shepherd who is ailing, the milkmaid who is glum, the cobbler who is wailing from nailing his thumb. When they're beset and besieged, the folk not noblessly obliged, however do they manage to shed their weary lot? Oh, what do simple folk do? We do not.
I have been informed by those who know them well. They find relief in quite a clever way. When they're sorely pressed,
They whistle for a spell, and whistling seems to brighten up their day. And that's what simple folk do, so they say.
They whistle?
So they say.
What else do the simple folk do to perk up the heart and get through? The wee folk and the grown folk who wander to and fro have ways known to their own folk we throat folk don't know. When all the doldrums begin, what keeps each of them in his skin? What ancient native custom provides the needed glow? Simple folk do you know?
Once upon the road, I came upon a lad singing in a voice three times his size. When I asked him why, he told me he was sad, and singing always made his spirits rise. And that's what simple folk do, I surmise.
They sing.
I surmise.
Arise, my love, arise, my love. Apollo's light in the skies, my love. The meadows shine with columbine and daffodils blossom away. Hear Venus call to one and all. Come taste delight while you may. The world is bright and all is right and life is merry and gay.
What else do the simple folk do? They must have a system or two. They obviously outshine us at turning tears to mirth. Have tricks a royal highness is Midas from birth. What then, I wonder, do they to chase all the goblins away? They have some tribal sorcery you haven't mentioned yet. Oh, what do simple folk do to forget?
Often I am told they dance a fiery dance and whirl till they're completely uncontrolled. Soon the mind is black and all are in a trance, a violent trance astounding to behold. And that's what simple folk do, so I'm told. Sit around and wonder what royal folk would do, and that's what simple folk do.
Oh, no, really?
I have it on the best authority.
Yes, that's what simple folk do.
Philanthropic labor, Danny down Dell, Danway is hell. Oh, why on goodness, why?
It's been depressing all the way,
Danny down,
and getting glummer every day,
Danny down.
How about to burn a little town or slay a dozen men? Anything to laugh again.
Oh, why on goodness, why?
Bye.
when I think of the rollicking pleasures that earlier filled my life. Lolly-lo, lolly-lo. Like the time I beheaded a man who was beating his naked wife. Lolly-lo, lolly-lo. I can still hear his widow say, never moving from where she lay, tell me what can I do? I beg, sir, of you, your kindness to repay.
Fie on goodness, fie! Fie on goodness, fie!
Lechery and vice have been arrested.
Arrested?
Not a maiden is ever more in threat. Virgins may wander unmolested.
Unmolested?
Lolly Lolet, get it a swift home, my own goodness, my, 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 my.
How we roared and brawled in Scotland.
Yeah.
Not a law was e'er obeyed.
Yeah.
And when wooing called in Scotland.
Yeah.
Scotland,
yeah.
Stroking someone's body.
Fie on Scotland, fie! Fie on Scotland, fie! No one repents for any sin now. Every soul is immaculate and trim.
Immaculate!
No one is covered with chagrin now. Nonny, no nim, dead but it's grim. Oh, fie on goodness, fie! Fie!
Folly to deplore, Derry Down, Derry Down.
Confession Sunday is a bore, Derry Down, Derry Down.
But to spend a tortured evening staring at the floor, guilty and alive once more.
Oh, fie on virtue, fie! Fie on mercy, fie! Fie on justice, fie on goodness, fie!
Thank you.
with her bold cavalier, and as swords rang through the hall, lance escaped them one and all. On a day dark and drear came to trial Guinevere, ruled the jury for her shame, she be sentenced to the flame.
Early dawn was the time she would pay for her crime. Onward, Lancelot, reappear, come and rescue Guinevere.
I'll wager the king himself is hoping you will return. Why would he have chosen 5 a.m. for the queen to burn? When the world is black and gray, what time would be more ideal for Lancelot to come and steal Guinevere?
As the dawn filled the sky on the day she would die, there was wonder far and near. Would the king burn Guinevere?
Then suddenly earth and sky were dazed by a pounding roar. And suddenly through the dawn an army began to pour. And lo, ahead the army holding aloft his spear, came Lancelot to save his dear Guinevere.
By the score fell the dead, as the yard turned to red. Countless numbers felt his spear, as he rescued Guinevere.
From December to December, before you drift to sleep upon your cot, think back on all the tales that you remember of Camelot. Ask every person if he's heard the story, and tell it strong and clear if he has not, that once there was a fleeting wisp of glory called Camelot.
Camelot, Camelot, I know in years a person was, but in Camelot, Camelot, those were the legal laws.
Where once it never rained till after sundown, by 8 a.m. the morning fog had flown. Don't let it be forgot that once there was a spot for one brief shining moment